A K-State veterinarian embodies both a human and an animal spirit, and here at the College of Veterinary Medicine, our faculty practice what they teach. Every day is different, presenting new challenges as we care for our closest animal friends and establish nutrition, health, and wellness protocols that protect not just our animals, but also the health and livelihoods of humans. We seek to gain the trust of our animals, and in turn, gain not only your trust, but your hearts. This is our K State of Mind.
Okay, here we go.
My arm is getting tired.
Is everybody excited today? Yeah, I'm Dr. Chris Blevins. I've been a veterinarian since 2006. I graduated from Kansas State Vet School. I just wanted to be around large animals more than anything. Because raised on a farm, I helped my uncle with a dairy. Used to go to quarter horse shows, ride horses, so I enjoyed horses too. Funny thing is, I didn't know actually dogs and cats can live in somebody's house because we'd always have just farm stuff until I married my wife, which was a classmate, and the dog would sleep in our bed with us. So we're at the horse unit here this morning to check a mare. We're managing through breeding to try to get her pregnant. The mare is now coming into estrus or heat. Currently, I ordered semen from the stallion destination, which is not here but in Texas. And so they collected the stallion yesterday and cooled it, put some extender, and they're shipping it FedEx to the vet school that should show up today. So it's a one-day shipment. And I'm just going to check the mare to make sure she's still where I expect her to be prior to breeding. So I'm just checking her this morning. And then we'll breed her once we get the semen, probably later this morning. Also, while we're out here this morning, we're going to put a Caslix in one mare that's already pregnant for the animal science unit. And that's to prevent an infection while she is carrying that fetus. There you go. Getting close, that was a blood vessel. There. Yep. So go in. There. Now rotate it around a little bit. There it is. There it is. See it?
Yeah.
Good job. Good. Good. That's the multiple small follicles and stuff there that's on that one. Oh, you're over. Are you over on the left? Oh, yeah. Yeah, you're over on the left. Good. Yeah, there's the dominant follicle. You saw it?
Yeah.
This is Delta. She is a mare that is to foal, but we don't know her foal date because she was rescued. And so what we're doing is just a physical exam, making sure she's healthy and happy. So we're going to get just a little bit of secretions from her mammary glands here. So it's a full watch, yep, so we'll just do it right in here. So it's just a stall side, and we'll just suck up some of that milk that you have to put a little reagent in with it, and it turns colors once the calcium's high enough. So we're watching to see if the colors change. So once it turns blue with just a little bit, then we're going to bring her to the vet school. Then we're going to continue to monitor her and get ready for a potential C-section. So there's things in, they'll start ultrasounding because she's getting closer. And so that's what we're checking. You're a good girl, aren't you? Yes. She says, I'm pretty too, and everybody knows it. So we're out here just outside of Manhattan, Kansas on a field call. And we're here today to do vaccines and also dentals on a couple horses. So it's like preventative medicine here today. The shot that we're going to give is actually the core innervator. So it has the rabies, West Nile, Eastern Western tetanus all in just one shot. So it's a new one by... No, it's been really a good vaccine. No reactions to it. I mean, if we wanted to add, I mean, the other shot that would have to be separate would be a rhino flu if they're going to be around other horses and all that other stuff. But I'm pretty sure last time we were out here, we just did core on them. But so we're going to put him in the stocks and look in his mouth. So we want him to be sleepy or at least sedate while we're doing that. So that's why we're going to give him some drugs, is just based on doing a dental exam and treatment and floating. Most stallions, they don't really move. Good. Spray it again. Perfect. So dental, we're gonna take and look inside the mouth, see what's going on. And what floating is actually just rasping off sharp points or any kind of teeth that might be a little bit long. So we'll use some instruments that actually grinds down different parts of the mouth. Some don't need it as often as others, but you know, a lot of our domesticated horses, because we feed them so nicely, some lush, even hays, that they usually don't chew as evenly, and so they'll have uneven wear just based on chewing. That's why Mustangs, everybody's asked, why don't you have to float Mustangs' teeth? Well, they eat more roughage, and it's really, really roughage, and so they really have to chew it, and they usually wear their teeth fairly well. So this is a speculum. We're gonna put this in the horse's mouth and hold their mouth open, and the plate sits on their front teeth, so that's how we're gonna take and get the horse to open its mouth. You can't just say, tell the horse to say, aw. So Madison is just looking inside the mouth to see what kind of examination or what we're finding inside there based on treatment. So she's doing her exam, and then I'll have her kind of tell me what she's finding. I'll look in there, see if I agree with her, and then she'll learn from that opportunity. And then we'll do treatments, which will be floating. So the 206 was the one that was kind of loose. We'll have to see and feel, see if it feels loose or not.
It did wiggle a little bit.
Okay.
I put my hand in.
Okay. Calibay here is an older stallion, and sometimes they get to the point where they'll have teeth that are wearing out and getting loose. And so we have a tooth that's actually a cheek tooth, but it's kind of closer to the front of the mouth that's really loose. So probably give it a grade 3 looseness. So we're gonna take and do a block around it. So we're gonna locally block around it, and then we're gonna extract it. But it'll still make his mouth a lot more comfortable just getting that kind of out of his mouth there. So for comfort and for pain and function, that's why we're gonna extract this tooth and rotate it, the other way. Hey, hey! See that? See the blunted edges?
Mm-hmm.
Good job.
Dr. Blevins is great to work with. It's really nice, especially getting out in the field and actually seeing the horses in their own environment and being able to kind of get on the routine vet care that they really need.
Just understanding the whole gamut of veterinary medicine and interacting with people, I didn't know how much I really enjoyed that aspect of it too, and it is a big part of it. You know, talking with people, it's their livelihood. Sometimes it's their jobs, right? When you get into the livestock side of things. And these animals mean a lot to them, and it's nice to be around those kind of people because they mean a lot to us. So I just really enjoy the students, enjoy all the staff and faculty that helps push me and keep learning every day. I always tell the profession is part of learning all the time. Mm-hmm.